His Excellency, the British High Commissioner, Mr. Amitabh Kant, Secretary, Department of Industry, Industrial Policy and Promotion, the Government of India, Arvind Singhji, Mr. Tarun Das, Mr. Godrej, Mr. McDonald, Mr. Sondi, thank you for that lovely opening. Senior officials of the Government of Rajasthan and senior management of JCB, friends, members of the media, first of all, I want to just say, I won't begin the way I thought I would begin. I just want to congratulate Lord Bamford for the manner in which he has put all of this together. We share something in common, Lord Bamford. And I think it's very, very important for us to put our finger on that point, and you started with that. You said, we are a family business with family values, and that is where it begins. When we began with Rajasthan, we said that this is about family Rajasthan. When we bring people together, apart from their castes, their creeds, and their religions, and we join them in this family value system, the power and the energy that you get out of it is really quite inconceivable. So when you speak about Team JCB, we speak about Team Rajasthan. And we understand each other because we are going down the same path. For me, it's a proud privilege to welcome you and your team to Rajasthan. To know that you have put up your first plant in Pune, that you've gone on to put up another in Vallabhgarh, and that Rajasthan is now going to be home to two huge plants of yours, that Rajasthan is going to be given the privilege to work with you in producing these wonderful machines. And I have to tell you that I don't know them by any other name. But when people ask me what is the kind of equipment that you would require for this kind of construction work, we all know it as JCB. Absolutely right, Mr. Das. If you go into the villages and you go into the countryside, no one knows what a backhoe is. But they certainly know what a JCB is. And I think that is extremely important. The gentleness and the kindness with which you have put your team together and you haven't forgotten them anywhere is something that we need to all, without exception, take on board. How beautifully you opened this, but you never forgot the team behind it. All those people who have supplied to you, all those people who continue to work with you, have not been forgotten. And I can tell you, in time to come, they will give back because they cannot forget or get away from someone who has wrapped them in family value and family affection. And that is how this plant will progress further, because I see that is how we work here in Rajasthan. So I will welcome you today very, very warmly, and I'll say that Rajasthan is on its journey towards becoming one of the important states in India. You know, we've always, whenever anyone speaks of Rajasthan, you first think of forts, and you think of palaces, you think of color, and you think of tourism, and you think of all the nice things and the good times that people can have. And perhaps that's where it ends. But we have a lot more to offer. Imagine being able to enjoy your workplace as much as you enjoy the surroundings. This doesn't happen everywhere. To be able to put the two together and to do it successfully, that's the art that the people of Rajasthan have understood. I don't really have to say it to anybody, but I think everybody here knows that any people of Rajasthani origin that have gone out abroad, staked their claim, set up their industries, have always done well. Whether you start with Lakshmi Mittal, the many, many others who are there, all of them have given back to the countries that they've gone to, but have also waved the flag for Rajasthan. And that is the culture that you're setting your factory up in, and I know that you would have studied it all before you came here. It's not just about what has happened, but what is going to happen. And so when you say that today is about the future, I completely agree with you. Today is about the future. It's about how we're going to change things. It's how we're going to make more energy flow. It's about how we're going to set up some of these and how we're going to make things easy for people to come and do business in the state. We are very lucky that we have a new government, our Prime Minister, full of energy, new ideas, new thoughts, and no fear about thinking out of the box. This is very important. Sometimes people say it could be rash, but I would say very categorically that this is extremely important, because if you cannot take the risk, then there are no gains. And following in his very illustrious footsteps, we've also taken up the programs that he talked about. And when I walked into your factory today and we met the welders, the ladies from the different districts who've done this amazing work over here, you mentioned to me that it's very important, the skilling process. They're very happy to tell you that that's a very, very important program now of the Government of India, but also of the Government of Rajasthan. In 2003-2008, two of our most important programs were actually bringing people into financial inclusion, and at that time it wasn't fashionable. The second one was about actually trying to skill people through a livelihood mission which we started. And that has now both taken off with huge support from the Government of India. And now today I see that Rajasthan government has been chosen as one of the leading lights in this particular area. I'm very happy to tell you that we're going to be setting up ITIs which are being powered by different states. Singapore, for example, is helping us work just now with an ITI in Udaipur. These are going to be training skills. I'm looking at a university which is going to be creating skills for our youth. We have promised to our youngsters 15 lakh jobs in the next 5 years. It's a very tall order. It's a very tall order. But with the support of the Government of India, I am sure that we can do it. And therefore, I can promise you our full support and let you know that side by side with you, as your factory grows, so will the skilled people of our state. We will match you stride for stride, hopefully, and we'll be able to give you the people that you require here, right here. I'm also very pleased to tell you that under this program, a lot of the industry in Rajasthan is working with the Government of Rajasthan to create the skill development. There are almost 40 industries across the country that have started to work with us, and those in Rajasthan are also, like yourselves, working to improve skills in and on the shop floor. I'm very sure that Rajasthan will not disappoint you in any way. I'm very sure that we will match you stride for stride. And I would like to tell you that in time to come, please believe that the Government of Rajasthan will walk shoulder to shoulder with you, will support you in whatever ventures you have. And I believe, Lord Bamford, that you could be, and perhaps would be, Rajasthan's ambassador to the rest of the world. Because if we work well, and we put things together properly, I'm sure that when you go out, you will talk about the ease of business, you will talk about the state, you will talk about how wonderful it is to work in the state, and that for us will be a very big thing. So today, I would just like to say that this very popular brand has got off to an amazing start. I not only just congratulate you and the rest of the JCB group, but also Family JCB, who we have just had the opportunity of meeting when you actually unveiled the factory. I know that in time to come, there's going to be huge investments in Rajasthan. The people who have invested now, like Neem Rana Investments and your investments in this Mahindra World City, is going to make a lot of difference to the people of this state and to people outside, give a message to bring other people into the state. Do you know, Lord Bamford, when I first came to government in 2003, I saw that we had a lack of industry, and it was very important because I would have to promise the youth that they would have to be part of the building up of the state. I rang Anand Mahindra because at that time Anand Mahindra had started the SEZ in Chennai and was doing very well. And I gave him a call and I said, I would like you people to come, please. Do what you've done in Chennai. Set up a world city over here. I will provide you the land and we will support you in any way. Well, he came here and we set up the world city in record time. I remember as chief minister when I went first to Goa, I had just become chief minister. Everybody else was talking about elections coming, they were talking about the kind of people that they wanted, and when my time came to speak, I had very little experience, so I didn't know how I was going to go about it, but I did say that there's a wealth of industry sitting over here, and I'd be very delighted if some of them came. And I am looking to see companies like Infosys and Wipro coming here because Rajasthan has not moved towards technology. We need to bring them in. Just behind me, immediately after me, the person who came to speak was the head of Wipro, Mr. Premji. And you know, businessmen don't mince words. So he said, in no uncertain terms, you know, Rajasthan is not a state that I would go to. And he gave me a lot of reasons why this would not happen. And since it's my first exposure, I can tell you, I was rather downcast. But I decided we were going to make this happen. And I want to tell you that immediately after the World City came about, the first two people to invest here was Mr. Narayan Murthy with Infosys and Mr. Azim Premji with Wipro. So that was a beginning. Then the financial services, very important, Deutsche Bank coming in, now yourselves and after yourselves, many other interesting things with the Manipal University coming up. And a lot of interesting things happening, not just in Jaipur, but in other parts of Rajasthan. I do believe that we're going to be able to bring the Prime Minister's dream of making India come true. And you head that team. Thank you very, very much for being here with us today. Mr. Kant, I'm very pleased to have you. I'm extremely pleased to have Mr. Das and Mr. Godrej. Thank you very much for being here. The team that comes with you, His Excellency and Mr. Sondhi, who had the pleasure of meeting, and I know are going to be able to make this thing happen, make it work, and I promise you, we will chip in with whatever we have to do. Again, from all of us here today, from Team Rajasthan and Family Rajasthan, a very warm welcome to Family JCP.